everyone, Christina Werner here. Welcome to another video for SimonsStamp.com. Today I'm starting with the Stronger Together stamp set. I'm going to be using it for my card today. Before I get to the stamping, I'm going to do a little bit of watercoloring. I have some Canson XL watercolor paper here. I'm going to cut it down to a smaller piece and then adhere it to a hardboard. Today I'm going to be using the Gonzai Tombi Portable 14 color set from Zig and Kuretake. And I'm going to be painting some very simple rainbow stripes on this. I love doing very simple watercolor backgrounds like this. They're quick and easy, and anyone can do them no matter what watercolor set you have. I'm picking up the colors directly from the palette without mixing them and just painting them in a rainbow fashion and a little bit of a diagonal sweeping up toward the kind of top corner of my watercolor paper. I've gone from a nice rose pink to a golden yellow. Now I've got a green, and I'm going to bring in a blue shade that will go over that green area and kind of transition going all the way up. So I want to make sure I have enough paint on my project here that they all start to sort of mix on my project. Now I'm going to take this blue shade, get it nice and juicy, and then bring it over to my project. There are two blues in this watercolor set. Just depends on which color you want. I decided that I wanted to go with this other blue. It's a little bit more vibrant. So I painted that on. And then I'm going to grab a purple shade up near the top. Now at this point, the pink near the bottom was starting to dry and I wanted it to be a little bit more intense. So I am going to go back over that pink area with just a little bit more color. It's going to intensify that rose shade and get it going a little bit. I also tipped up my hardboard here so that I could get the colors moving and mixing a little bit more on my project. And this, I did this as opposed to actually mixing the colors on a palette. So I grabbed a heat tool to speed along the drying process. You could also just let this air dry. It would look great. But adding a little bit of heat and some air to this does intensify or speed up all of that drying. After everything was dry, I removed it from my hardboard. And now I'm going to do some stamping over the top using that stamp set. So this is the Stronger Together stamp set. There's a lot of little outline flowers, and I wanted to stamp as many of them at once as possible, but I knew I needed to perform some stamp surgery and cut off a stem here so that I could stamp just the top portion. When I want to use that stamp together again, I can just mount them on a block or in my Misty stamp positioning tool together instead of keeping them apart. I used some clear embossing ink from Simon and then stamped these two large outline floral images. After I stamped them, I sprinkled on some alabaster embossing powder from Brutus Monroe. This is a nice bright white embossing powder. And then I grabbed my heat tool once again and just heat set this embossing powder until it was smooth and melted. Now that I have the first stamping done, I'm going to go ahead and add additional stamps. This very large cluster of flowers and leaves that I stamped in that same clear ink. And then I applied that same embossing powder. I like to do it in stages like this so that I can see where the first areas were stamped and line up the second stamps accordingly. I then trimmed down my piece so that the white edges weren't showing. It ended up being 5 inches tall by 3¾ inches wide. So it's the perfect dimensions for an A2 size card. It's going to have a nice a white border around the outside edge and with the perfect sizing. So I just trimmed that down with my paper trimmer. And then I prepped my card base. My card base is made out of some Nina Classic Crest Solar White 110-pound cardstock. And I just scored that at 5.5 to create a top folding card. I then put some foam adhesive on the back of my watercolor piece, and I was not shy with the foam adhesive. Foam adhesive tends to flatten out your watercolor panels too, so if your watercolor panel is a little warped, put some foam adhesive on the back and adhere it to your card, and that usually flattens it out. Here's a greeting from that Stronger Together stamp set. Just stamped it onto some white cardstock using some VersaFine Onyx Black ink, and then used my scissors to trim it out. This is going to allow me to pop up that greeting on some foam tape to add a little bit more dimension to my card. So I cut down some foam strips to be a little bit more narrow to go behind these greeting strips, and then adhered them to the front of my card. And that finishes the card for today. This is a really simple project. There are lots of different ways that you can add watercolor or color behind the flowers before you stamp them. You could easily do this by dragging some ink pads across or even doing some ink blending, anything like that. There's a lot of different ways that you can add color behind outline images. Thanks so much for watching today. I'll be back very soon with another card video.